Hello everyone, this is Revans from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 254. Ola S1 and Ola S1 Pro deliveries will begin from December 15. Both the scooters were launched on August 15 in India. An owner of an Apple MacBook Pro had just recently suffered from minor injuries as the laptop's battery spontaneously combusted into flames. The laptop in question was a 2015 MacBook Pro. For those unaware, this was the same model that was banned for some airlines as its battery was considered a potential fire hazard. The victim shows his hand that faces minor burns after trying to remove the burning laptop from under their bed. While the users face only the minor injuries, the potential damage could have been quite big as the flames would possibly have led to major property damage or even worse injuries. Thieves are now using Apple AirTags to steal luxury cars. Apple AirTags can be used to track keys and valuables in case they get lost. The Bluetooth-enabled device can be used as a keychain, and users can tuck them inside their wallets to locate their products in case of misplacement or theft. Now, Canada's York Regional Police Auto Department has issued a notice that warns about a new method used by car thieves to steal high-end vehicles via Apple AirTags. The police department claims that Apple AirTag is hidden almost everywhere in the car due to its small size. The notice issued earlier this month reads that the York region has reported 5 incidents where suspect placed a small tracking devices on the high-end car to steal them. Apple's product roadmap for 2022 has been revealed. The company is said to be working on a new iPad Pro, a redesigned MacBook Air, and a high-end iMac with an Apple Silicon, 3 new Apple Watch models. Apple's 2022 lineup will include iPhone 14 series as well. Jeff Bezos again trying to change the world now. Bezos Amazon is trying to find ways which would help scientists to dim the sun. Amazon Web Services recently created 30 simulation of what Earth could look like by the middle of this century based on the climatic change trajectories. In collaboration with Silver Lining, Amazon is studying solar radiation management. Meta has announced the arrival of a new split payments feature in the Facebook Messenger. This feature, as the name suggests, will let you calculate the split expenses with others right from the Facebook Messenger. This feature essentially looks to bring an easier method to share the cost of bills and expenses. For example, splitting a dinner bill with friends using the new split payment feature, Facebook Messenger users will be able to split bills evenly or modify the contribution for each individual, including their own. This new bill splitting feature is still in beta and will be exclusive to US users at first. The rollout will begin early next week. The world is transmitting more data today than ever in history. This is likely to increase almost 6 times between 2020 and 2025. Last year, the world generated around 33 zettabytes of data, and by 2025, this number could reach around 175 zettabytes, far outpacing the rate of growth of facility to store them. 1 zettabyte equal to a trillion gigabytes of data. There will also be a huge rise of demand of energy to run and maintain these facilities. An interesting prospect to meet this storage demand lies inside the human body. Since the 1950s, scientists have discussed the possibility of using DNA as a way of storing data. At the outset, the proposition may sound a little out of the place, but it is a possibility. DNA can be described as a molecule that stores all the genetic instructions needed to shape ever-living organisms. That's a lot of information, and we have a copy of all that information in a single cell in our body. The computers store information as binary digits or bits, zeros and ones. These bits are used as code to instruct programs to run. Similarly, DNA has 4 nucleic acid bases, A, T, G, and C, which are strung together in different combinations to form genes. Researchers say the goal of DNA-based data storage is to encode and decode binary data to and from synthesis strands of DNA. After LG announced that it's exiting the smartphone business, the company promised 3 years of OS updates to its flagship phones in order to extend their life cycle and make sure loyal users are not left disappointed. But starting from next month, the Korean tech giant will no longer provide keys to unlocking bootloaders. Madhya Pradesh college students makes an electric car that runs 185 km on a single charge. The electric car takes 4 hours to fully charge and can be charged for just Rs. 30. The project car can seat up to 5 passengers and can achieve a top speed of 50 km per hour. Oppo accidentally revealed the launch date of its first foldable smartphone. The company announced the Oppo InnoDay 2021 for December 14th and 15th. We can expect this smartphone to be releasing on the Oppo InnoDay 2021. Oppo and League of Legends mobile game have announced a new Oppo Reno 7 Pro League of Legends mobile game limited edition will be launching officially today. Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition support page reveals a design before going down, and it is expected to launch in January 2022. Samsung could finally launch Snapdragon-powered S22 series in India. Samsung expected to launch S22 lineup with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset, and it could launch on January 8, 2022. Xbox Series X Halo Infinite Limited Edition bundle hits Maharashtra on Monday, Delhi on Wednesday. 90% was already pre-booked. Amazon and Flipkart listing should have happened next week. If at all, we can expect standard edition after that. Moto Edge X30 could be the first smartphone with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset. It is also confirmed to sport a 5000mAh battery with a 68W fast charging support. This handset will feature a 6.67 inch Full HD Plus OLED display. Moto is set to launch two new phones in India soon. One of the phones could be come with a Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset, while the other could be a Moto G series phone. Moto Edge X30 could launch in India with a different moniker, and Motorola will launch two new phones in the quarter 1 of 2022. Honor launched the X30 series in the late October with the X30i and X30 Max. Those are now about to be joined by a vanilla version, as Honor scheduled a launch for the Honor X30 on December 16th. TechnoSpark 80 is set to launch in India soon. Amazon India has put a microsite of this smartphone ahead of its launch. This smartphone will arrive as a successor to the TechnoSpark 70 that debuted in June this year. Acer Predator Helios 500 was launched in India on Monday. This laptop comes with 11th generation Intel Core i9 and features a 120Hz mini LED display. It also carries a Thunderbolt 4 ports, and it comes with a DTS:X ultrasound. This laptop is aimed at hardcore gaming enthusiasts and PC gamers looking to play graphically demanding games. Acer Predator Helios 500 price in India starts at ₹3,79,999. This laptop will be available for purchase in the country through the Acer online store, exclusive stores, and authorized retail stores. Realme 9A specifications have been surfaced online. This phone is said to come with a Snapdragon 680 processor, a 50-megapixel primary camera, and a Full HD Plus LCD display with a 90Hz refresh rate. Realme 9 series is expected to debut in the first half of 2022. Redmi 10 2022 have received the FCC certification with the model number displayed on the screen. The listing reveals the phone will arrive with the Android 11 based MIUI 12.5, up to 6GB of RAM and a 128GB of storage, and a 4G LTE. Redmi 10 2022 is expected to launch soon. Xiaomi is expected to announce the Xiaomi 12, Xiaomi 12X and Xiaomi 12 Pro smartphones on December 28th. And the Xiaomi 12 family includes two Lite branded models such as Xiaomi 12 Lite and the Xiaomi 12 Lite Zoom. WhatsApp has started rolling out waveforms for voice messages you send or receive on the platform. The latest change is initially in place for selected beta testers on both Android and iOS. WhatsApp replaces the original interface for audio messages by showing up voice waveforms on chat bubbles. In addition to waveforms for beta testers, WhatsApp has been spotted testing an option that would allow users to turn off all notifications you get from message reactions. Message reactions are yet to be released for beta testing. Samsung Galaxy Tab S8 series were shared by Evan Blaze on Twitter. This shows out the 11-inch Tab S8, 12.4-inch Tab S8 Plus, and the 14.6-inch Tab S8 Ultra displays. The two smaller slates have the familiar look to the outgoing Galaxy Tab S7 series, while the Ultra variant sports a notch as rumored previously. Gaming tablets are rare, but Lenovo is making one. It will be a part of its Legion series. Actually, we can barely call this tablet, assuming that the rumors are true. According to the leaks, two photos were shared by the Lenovo executives on Weibo. One shows the front of the tablet and the other the Legion branding on the back. This tablet is visibly on the smaller side. Jio has received its Disney Plus Hotstar mobile prepaid plans in India. The plans now cost ₹601, ₹799,066, ₹3,199, and ₹659. The new plans bring benefits like up to 3GB of data, unlimited voice calls, 100 SMSs per day, and Disney Plus Hotstar mobile plans. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share, and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.